Hi guys, let's see one of the neat pattern questions. A similar question came in 2016. Anyways, I'm going to see what is the level at which need comes. First of all, a common thing is need is a higher level. No, it's actually a lower level asked differently. For example, what I have here is how many electrons are present in an orbital with quantum number n equals 4, l equals 1. Answers given are 2, 6, 10 and 14. Now, let me take a minute to tell you, on average, you need to solve chemistry in 1 hour. And I would like my students to solve all 45, but a minimum of 35. So it seems like roughly you have less than 2 minutes a question. So when I read this question, roughly 2 minutes irukku nama solalam. But let's see how many minutes this needs to get the right answer fast. Now, you can see n equals 4 means the orbital is 4, l equals 1 is p orbital, 4p. Okay, this is going fundamentally. It's a 4p orbital. For even state board students, you would know that a p orbital will be designed like this. Okay. And if you look into your Hund's rule and Pauli's exclusion principle, and then you look at it, okay, 4p orbital, how many number of electrons, think for a second. And the most commonly answer for this one is 6, and that's what NEET wants you to answer. The devil is in the details. What they want you to do is read the question right. How many electrons are present in an orbital? Okay, the key word here is an orbital. This is 3 orbitals. An orbital is just 1. It doesn't matter s orbital, p orbital, d orbital, f orbital. In an orbital, the answer is always 2. You don't need to do any of this. An orbital. The training, how it goes is, the key word success pandra habits, class la teach pandra. It has to come for you. Your paper should have had this circle. Once you do this, let's see this again. How many electrons are present in an orbital with quantum number? First, I understand the question, about 10 seconds. Then, okay, the keyword is an orbital. Then, ura dabba, 2. Then the answer is this, 15 seconds. Then what you did was, you saved about a minute and 45 for the next tougher question. That's the level at which need comes. Ella question ku ore mari time irukadu, inda mari question la answer pannanum. But the problem with this question is, easy one where plus 4 can become minus 1. Let's see one more question. This is actually AIPMT 2005. AIPMT is NEET right now, 2005 question. So when you look at the question, it's asked for what is the correct relationship between the isomolar solution of sodium oxide, sodium sulfide, sodium selenide and sodium telluride. pH oda comparison kekkranga. At the first look, it will seem like ionic equilibria question. This is where NEET is different. Chapters will be mingled. Okay? If you had sat in my class, you would have known that this doesn't come under ionic equilibria at all. This will come under periodicity. Ana, or previous year paathinga ionic equilibria la ezhudirukum. Now look at this one. They are asking you Na2O, Na2S, Na2SE and Na2TE. There is always a pattern in chemistry. And the pattern is how I teach for you. Now let's take this one. Na2O, Na2S, Na2SE, Na2TE. So these belong to the sodium salts of same group, oxygen group. So we are looking at O2 minus, S2 minus, SC2 minus and TE2 minus. Now, look at these are bases. Look at the corresponding acids. This is what I would have taught you in periodicity. A corresponding acid for this would be H2S, not exactly a conjugate. This differs by 2 hydrogen, but still H2O, H2S, H2SE, H2TE. Now we are in the comfort zone. In periodicity, I would have taught you that as you go down the series for hydrogen acids, the acidity increases. So, mele endu kele pona increase agudun sonna. Then corresponding bases ke enna agum basicity, I would have told you that when you go from top to bottom, basicity decreases. So, this is more basic than this one, this is more basic than this one, this is more basic than this one. That tells me this is more basic than this is more basic compared to this is more basic than this. Higher the basicity, higher the pH. So Na2O should have the highest pH. Now that alone tells me this answer is wrong. This is what you do in NEET. First of all, the reason I eliminate is now it looks easier, much better for me. Then in a periodic trend, unless I have given you an exception, you are never going to see this. Okay, right away. Now this behaves the trend. pH 1 meaning pH of Na2O is higher because it's basic. You know, other corresponding acid on the weak. So all this would take probably about 15 to maximum 30 seconds if you want to reread the question. Training, straightforward you look at it and answer. But where the training comes is, for an untrained person, this is ionic equilibria. For a trained person, the fundamental is periodicity, the answer lies in ionic equilibria pH.